Greetings, developers. This is Wesley Chun from Google. Today, we're going to cover the hot topic of where to put your files in the cloud. I'm really excited to introduce and describe the various storage options that are available in Google's cloud so you can determine which may be right for you, enabling you to build that next viral or even non-viral app. The first pair of cloud storage options we'll cover in this episode are Google Cloud Storage and Google Drive. If you're a developer, you may be wondering, what is the difference between Google Drive and Google Cloud Storage? I go to many tech conferences every year, and this is a question that comes up regularly. Aren't they both storage in the cloud? Well, the answer is, why yes, they are. Both utilize the same underlying storage mechanism provided by Google's infrastructure, but the service offerings differ both for users as well as developers. Let's dig a little deeper into each. Google Drive isn't part of the Google Cloud platform, but instead is a service tightly integrated with the Google Apps ecosystem. It's for creating and editing documents, sharing, collaborating, and syncing your docs and personal files to multiple devices. Most users interact with Drive from the web interface or mobile app. So yes, there is a consumer aspect to Drive, but it's for developers too. Google Drive provides a RESTful web API for developers, both client and server side, as well as SDKs for Android and iOS. These features allow you to build web or mobile apps that give your users access to their Drive files and folders. What kind of apps can you write? Spell checking documents, creating new docs based on the contents of a Google Sheet. In fact, in the Google Drive API documentation, you'll find open source starter projects that edit text files in Drive folders or unzip files into a Drive folder. Click the link to get access to those samples. You can also access the Google Drive API from Google Apps Script, which is JavaScript outside the browser. It's server-side like Node, but runs on Google servers and gives users programmatic access to data in Google Apps and other Google services, including Google Drive. Take a look at the short code snippet here. It's just simple JavaScript that loops through your Google Drive files and logs the file names to the console. If you're familiar with add-ons for Google Docs and Sheets, they're powered by AppScript. How many of you have ever edited a Google Doc simultaneously with other users? I sure have, and we do it every day. Well, guess what? You can create your own apps that let multiple people sign on and collaborate together using the Google Drive Realtime API. How cool is that? Got an app you'd love to see? There's no need to wait for Google to write it when you can do it yourself. We empower you to scratch that itch. Now that you know what Google Drive is, what about Google Cloud Storage? What do they have in common? Well, in both cases, you've got data that's persistent, fast, scalable, and highly available. Both provide access control for individuals or groups. However, large-scale data, such as backups, archives, big data, and the processing of that data is where Google Cloud Storage is a better fit. Cloud Storage is part of the Google Cloud platform where services are provided on behalf of a project or application rather than a user. Also, for some of you, it's critical to specify where your data should be hosted, and Cloud Storage supports that. At this time, you can select either the US or the EU. There are many ways by which you can access Google Cloud Storage. Through its web interface, the command line tool, which is part of the Google Cloud SDK, by using the App Engine client library for your App Engine apps, from Compute Engine instances using built-in service accounts that access cloud storage data within the same project, and the Cloud Storage RESTful API. One of the benefits from Cloud Storage is that you get access, or your data gets access, to other services in the Google Cloud platform. Cloud Storage data can be ingested into tools which let you query, normalize, transform or ETL, perform analysis on, or otherwise process all of your data. These tools include Google App Engine apps, your code running on Google Compute Engine virtual machines, Google BigQuery, which gives you the ability to analyze multiple terabytes of data in mere seconds, Google Cloud SQL, our fully managed, highly available relational database in Google's cloud, and Google Prediction, our cloud-based machine learning service. As you can see, Google Cloud Storage isn't just for storage. It's also an entry point. Okay, one last option for file storage in the cloud, persistent disk. Think of them as versatile hard drives in the cloud available for your fleet of Google Compute Engine virtual machines. While instances boot from persistent disks, their content lives independently of VM creation and destruction. Instances can mount multiple disks. You can mount persistent disks on multiple instances, read-only, or read-write if mounted only on one VM. And you have the ability to take a point-in-time snapshot of a persistent disk, then restore it to any Compute Engine region in the world. You can do any of these from Compute Engine's web interface, command line tool, or its RESTful web API. Now that you know about the different ways to store files in the cloud, which you choose depends on the type of app or solution you're building for your users. If it's working with documents or personal files, with the added benefits of collaboration and syncing, or otherwise interacting in a Google Apps domain, Google Drive is probably the best fit. If working with a massive amount of data, with a need to have fine-grained control over who can access it, or if you're doing large-scale analysis or computation with that data, possibly using other Google Cloud Platform services, I'd go with Google Cloud Storage. With Cloud Storage, you can easily pipe your data to App Engine, BigQuery, or Cloud SQL. If that data processing takes place on Google Compute Engine instances, you can easily transfer that data to Compute Engine's persistent disk just once and be able to access it from multiple instances. All right, now that you have all your options for file storage in the cloud, go out there and build that awesome app. If you want to learn more, check out our other DevBytes, including those which are data and storage related. Thanks for tuning in.